website, which was the present website, was built in 2010. At that time, it was considered to be a very much state of the art. And I think in 2010, we were pretty pleased with what we had. Unfortunately, technology has moved on very rapidly. The positions obtained then didn't last very long. Within a couple of years, iPads and smartphones had completely transformed the way that we use the internet. And as of last week, 58% of all visits to the council website came either from the mobile phone or the tablet. Until last week, we wouldn't be giving them the service that we think they ought to have had. The council website, when it's viewed on a phone or a tablet, was really very, very difficult to use. Links were too small, the structure was too complicated, you couldn't actually do any business with us very easily. Difficult to report a pothole, apply to the faucet bearer, pay the bill, or all that sort of thing. And it's pretty important to remember just how well used the council website is. These figures would be pretty surprising. In fact, when I asked for them, they would be surprising to me. In the last 12 months, to the end of September, it was visited 3 million times. 58,000 people a week, and almost two-thirds of them were logging onto a website they struggled to use. So we fixed it. I think we, of course, we, in the collective sense, we talked to the first-class technical staff that we have. Last week, we launched a completely redesigned, mobile-friendly website, which is based on absolute best practice in web design from around the country. The new site will automatically detect the kind of device that you're using to do it, and it will redesign itself automatically to suit that device. Every page of content has been rewritten, streamlined, and made simpler and easier to use. Just under 1,000 residents took part in user testing to help design it, and the feedback we've had so far is showing that it works. People are finding it easy to use, and they're giving us almost universal positive feedback. The project was completed entirely in-house, we'll be glad to know. We used open source software, which is free, and the only resource we've spent over and above the time our office is on the site was a £10,000 grant from the LGA. So the council now has what we believe confidently is a fully responsive, modern, well-designed, well-written transactional website, which is amongst the best of its kind in the country, and we're pretty proud of the fact that a lot of other authorities we anticipate will be coming to us for advice on how we achieve it. So I'd say that's really full marks to our professional officers. Work. when they have something to work, they have to get up to and back down from it. The old lift is a mechanical, electrically powered device that needs regular maintenance, and so it was done. The new lift, members may notice it's a door lift. Now, I know the propaganda suggested that it was a strange sort of luxury lift, but in fact, it rains outdoors, and that's why the lift is covered with glass, not only to keep our employees dry, but also because of water and electricity are not good friends. But you're quite right, and that did not prevent some propaganda's allusion to luxury. On the matter of the Downton Abbey staircase, the propaganda perhaps conjured images of a luxurious polished mahogany with duchesses floating down them. It is in fact a painted steel structure, very similar to the one I walked up and down early in the 1960s when I worked in the glass furnaces of Llanwern. It was that sort of a Downton Abbey staircase.
Really?
That, of course, we only had a British iron and steel industry. But I believe that the glass furnaces on I worked on were laid silent under Mrs. Thatcher, not many years after Ted Heath took us into what is now the European Union. But the propaganda wasn't entirely untrue, I would say that. It's true, there was a new lift. It's true, there was a new staircase. They just didn't fit the propaganda descriptions. Now that sort of propaganda reminds me of the words of our great hymn writer, William Blake. The truth that's told with ill intent beats every lie you can invent.
As a Captain Jones, we learn every day, really. Can we know that before, please? Moving on to Cabinet Portfolio of Books and Social Services and Public Health. Any questions to Councillor Chris Jones? No questions? Okay. Can we know that before then, please? Moving on to Cabinet Portfolio for Leisure Sport. Any questions to Chris Mead? Councillor Chris Mead. Councillor
Chris, on item 5 on the libraries, can you report to Council the recent developments at Ridgeway Library and the potential for extended open hours?
Councillor Andrew Jones.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Chris, given that Council has spent some £49,000 on the new PR bureau and press office, and the Irby Library has experienced a considerable reduction in library hours, are you aware that yet again, on Saturday the 3rd of October, Irby Library was closed with no notice? Thank you.
Councillor Blake.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Council meeting, given the Council has spent £49,000 on a policy advisor, such as bin doctor, and extensions to the office for the Council leader, can you tell me why Figure 8 members who attend a pool, when that pool is closed, not deliberately closed because of shortage of staff, and they're told to travel to another location, why that money could not be used to keep all our pools open?
Any other questions? Councillor
Crispin.
Thank
you, Mr. Mayor.
I'm usually quite excited about what he's doing there.
Can we note Councillor Bean's report? Moving on to portfolio for environment, Councillor Bernie Mooney. Any questions for Councillor Bernie Mooney?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Given that Thornton Hoof is an important part of world tourism and heritage offer, and also that it is important economically holding four popular wedding venues, will the Cabinet member explain what they will be doing to address the increasing litter cost, specifically from cars travelling through the village, since the regular litter picks have been reduced significantly, especially in the light of £49,000 could be found for an advisory consultant and modifications to their office space. Any other questions?
Councillor Group.
Considering the controversy we were talking about the fines, people being fined to get up to do we have an idea of the breakdown of the fines? What fines have been given in relation to cigarettes? And also, it states that you've got 2 months' operation over 2,500 fixed penalty notices have been served. Do you know how many of them have been contested?
Any other questions?
No.
Absolutely.
Your question, and once again, as per usual on that side of the room, you take every opportunity you can and find a little tiny thing that you can hold on to, repeat and repeat and repeat without repeating the very fact that the reason that we're making so many cuts is because of the £151 reduction.
Further funding to replace any fire
unfortunately, home life is one of the school.
Sorry.
Yeah, it's the section in relation to counter-terrorism security. It's a challenge project that's going out throughout the authority. I hope it's presented to all councillors so that they'll be able to understand what is required for the mention of the
thanks, Councillor Mitchell. Councillor Tony
Smith. Okay, Councillor Smith. First of all, thanks, Councillor Brighton. It's an opportunity once a year to look at Pledge 2. Now, Pledge 2 is getting children ready for school. I do report annually on this. When we took over about two and a half, 3 years ago, the number of children who were ready for school, you might remember, this is one of my drivers, was about 44% of children were at the expected level at the end of the reception class. I'm able to report this year that there has been an increase in rural children achieving a good level in the early years foundation stage in school. I must say, these are provisional results. We've had a rise of 6.8% from 2014, and we now have 69.7% of children achieving the expected level. This compares with the national average rise of 6.2% and the national average of 66%. You know, the work that's been done by our early years people, by the teachers and that, has been a fantastic effort over the last 2 years. Been driven by our officers in the local authority. I mean, when I took over, my motivation was to try and get this up to 80% by 2016-17. I think we're well on the road to that. Another very useful or very important development is that children in our most disadvantaged areas. One of the criticisms we had from Oxford in the early years was that we were not reaching children in our most disadvantaged areas. We were not engaging with them. I can say that we are now engaging with 75% of children in our most disadvantaged areas. And that's talking about 1,283 children. We are now, as a local authority, 27 out of 152 authorities, so we are rising up the order, and hopefully we get into the top 10% of that. So that's excellent news, really, on Pledge 2 of that, and I want to see it continue. Pledge 3, very, very quickly, is getting young people ready for work and adult life. As was mentioned, there has been an increase in the number of children getting GCSEs and that. And again, these are provisional results, and there has been an increase of children receiving 580 from 69.2% to 72.8%, and also an increase of young people who are getting English and maths in those five. Now, it's not just GCSEs and that, it's also preparation for life for young people. And as was mentioned about the youth zone, some very exciting things are happening in regard to the youth zone and that. And that's responding to the question that was raised about it. We have appointed a national charity on side, and the manager is Stuart Barnes, who's taking over, and now has started fundraising for We will not have implication for any extra funding from the local authority, and I've been informed that the work will start in November. So that's really exciting news for the young people of Wirral and that. And again, you know, we've got to praise the people. But a lot of people are pessimistic that nothing would ever happen about this, but we've moved on really rapidly in regard to the youth tide, and I think it's going to be fantastic addition for young people and that. And again, yes, I think it is very important to make sure that everyone is involved in that. I do make it very, very clear, though, that without the teachers, without the classroom assistants, without the officers, we couldn't achieve the results that we are achieving. And we've got to continue that kind of work, because young children only get one opportunity in life, and that has got to be taken. And I want to ensure that the maximum number of early years are at the right level, and then it will make it easier for people in primary and secondary schools later on. Hope I've answered all the questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Smith, for those responses. Can we note that report, please? Okay, moving on to the final cabinet portfolio for highways. Any questions to Councillor Stewart, please?
It's on highways and transport, item 3, major schemes for vision dock bridges. Can the cabinet member offer assurances that the disruption is kept to a bare minimum during the work on the dock bridges, as I've had first hand experience in the past?
Further questions,
Councillor
Douglas.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. In the section 2 on the highway services contract, the comment is made, performance on the contract continues to be a focus for both partners. I wondered if that could be put into English for us. Does it mean that work is being delivered on time and to the quality required, or does it mean anything else?
So Brian Kent.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Can I ask the Cabinet Member if he can shed any light on the current progress with the LED lighting rollout, please?
Councillor Stewart. All those in favour of the recommendation in respect of the human resources policy and human abstentions?
One.
Any against?
One.
I now invite Councillor, I recommend, oh, sorry. That's carried. I now invite Councillor Davis to move the recommendation to approve the revised capital programme of 61.5 million. Is there a seconder? Okay. All those in favour of the recommendation to approve? Can I, just before we go to that vote, can I double check that that was first and that was seconded?
Yeah, I'm happy to move it,
Mr. Mayor. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, legal. Okay, can we have a vote on that, please? Votes for? Votes against? Any abstentions? That is carried. We now move on to item 7C on the agenda, a matter referred to Council by Cabinet. At its meeting on the 27th of July, I now ask Councillor Phil Davis to move the recommendation that the revenue budget 2015-16 be amended to reflect the reprofiling of the delivery of the savings programme, with this being funded through contributions from the families and wellbeing reserve, remodelling reserves and general fund balance. Is there a seconder? Oh, is there a yes? Yes. Is there a seconder? Okay. All those in favour to approve the amended revenue budget, please clearly indicate. Okay. Any votes against? Abstentions? One. That recommendation is carried. Item D. I will now invite Councillor Phil Davis to move the recommendation following the meeting of the Cabinet on the 10th of December, September, to approve the new capital scheme for inclusion within the overall capital programme.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Okay. All those in favour to approve a new capital scheme for inclusion within the overall capital programme? Okay. Any against? Any abstentions? One. That recommendation is carried. E. And finally, I invite Councillor Janet Williamson to move the recommendation following the transformation and Resources Policy and Performance Committee held on the 21st of September 2015 to approve the revised attendance management policy and procedure.
Second, Mr. Mayor.
Is there a second?
Mr. Mayor, am I allowed to ask a question on that particular item? So I was just wondering, you must have written to me about this, I just wondering what the current position is.
I'll do it. All those against? One against? And one abstention. That recommendation is carried. Thank you. Moving on to item 8, matters for noting. Item 8, page 189 to 190 on the agenda draws the attention of the Council to matters determined by the Cabinet, which in accordance with the Constitution, the Council is required to note. Cabinet 13th of July 2015, minute 25, financial monitoring outturn reports for 2014-15. Would somebody like to move that minute 25 be noted?
So moved, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Moving on to that requires a vote. Okay, all those in favour?
No.
All those against? Any abstentions? Well, that's carried. Item 9, members' questions. Moving on to item 9, general questions from members to either myself, a cabinet member or the chair of the committee on any matter which affects the borough or which is related to the council's power and duties. Notice has been given in accordance with standing orders 10(2)(b)(1) from Councillor Gilchrist to Councillor Phil Davis. Councillor Gilchrist.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. On page 20 of the cabinet report dealing with phase 1 of the delivery plan for the 2020 vision, it said, the council has a relatively traditional model of providing support for young people through a generic set of services, including youth centres. Later, reference is made to establishing a steering group to lead a review of current activity and identify future provision. What assurances can the leader give about the future of a South Wirral youth hub in this plan?
Awesome.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. And can I thank Councillor Gilchrist for advance notice of his question? Reply is as follows. I do welcome Councillor Gilchrist's interest in the 2020 pledges and the delivery plan we are developing, phase one of which was agreed at Cabinet last week. On the same page, he referenced in the delivery plan, it reports, and I quote, "It is clear that our ambitions must be delivered in partnership and we will establish a stakeholder group tasked with developing an innovative and creative approach," end quote. The young people of Wirral are surely one of the most important stakeholders in the development of youth services, and I'm delighted the plan commits us to complete targeted engagement activity with young people to identify what is important to them, which means that we will actually talk to young people before presuming that we, as elected members, can decide what is best for them. I'm sure Councillor Gilchrist and the Council will join with me in recognising that providing the sorts of services young people value and require in a manner appropriate for how they live and interact with the Council, each other, and the community is a sensible approach and one to be applauded. So as we make progress on understanding the needs of our young people across the whole borough, not just in South Wirral, I give Councillor Gilchrist my full assurance that I will keep both him and other members informed of our plans. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you.
Thank you. Moving on to item 10, matters referred from Policy and Performance Committee. In accordance with Standing Order 7(5), Council is asked to consider the recommendation in respect of the notices of motions that have been referred by the Council to Policy and Performance Committee. Can we note those items that have gone to the committee? Thank you. Moving on to 11, notices of motion. Council can now move to item 11 on the agenda, pages 195 to 100. And the Council is invited to consider the following notices of motion, which have been submitted in accordance with Standing Order 7, and which I consider are appropriate to be debated.
Mr. Mayor, I move that our motion take place and the Conservatives will be there that morning for us.
Okay. Is that agreed?
Yeah. Mr. Mayor, and the second motion would like to be held as well as successful business. Third motion, pulling the law, and the final motion, resolution.
Thank you. Is that agreed to those order of motion for debate?
Agreed.
Okay, can I have the first debate, please?
Sorry, Mr. Mayor. Also, I was in the brief that we were judging half a state.
Is that all in favour of half a state?
Mr. Mayor, if it's in order for me to question that, I suggest that 9 o'clock would be more appropriate.
Would the councillors agree that 9 o'clock is a more appropriate time?
No. What about quarter to nine, Mr. Mayor?
In their own homes. And again, I think that shows the warmth of spirit that exists within our community here in Wirral. And rest assured, we are keeping all of these kind of requests on the database for future reference. More generally, Mr. Mayor, I welcome the offer by the government of help to Syrian refugees, and we're working with civil servants as part of a coordinated Liverpool City Region approach to this issue. Now, I know that the original announcement by the government was for funding for 12 months. I noted that they now said that they will fund the Syrian refugees beyond the 12 months. I think we need to see some clarity about what that actually means. What are they going to fund over what kind of period beyond 12 months? Because clearly we need to make sure that we have got the resources, the wherewithal to provide a good quality of life and decent services for the people that we welcome into our borough. So I'll be looking for that clarity further down the line. Mr. Mayor, whilst I think it is right to work together across political parties, etc., I do want to place on record my concern by the government's announcement that they're placing a cap of 20,000 Syrian refugees that Britain will accept by 2020. I just worry that given the huge numbers currently seeking refuge, I'm concerned that an artificial cap over a five-year period of 20,000 will simply not be enough to meet the huge demand that exists at the moment. Indeed, many members may have seen the notice placed today in several national newspapers by 341 eminent judges, QCs, barristers, solicitors and law professors who say that the government's offer is too low, too slow and too narrow. So, Mr. Mayor, I would urge the government to work with our European partners to come up with a programme which doesn't contain an artificial cap and which is front-loaded, because I actually believe that many of these people in desperate need help now, not in 5 years' time. I really do believe that. So, Mr. Mayor, I hope that we can send a clear message from our discussion.